in the cool of the morning after a nice drencher on the northern Cali coast, so it's going to be, well, it is humid. The sun's coming out and sweating just standing, but we found us a toad. You can see hanging back quite a ways. Well, at least I think you can see it's hanging back quite a ways. So she clears the string at about 80 feet or so. It's probably about 6 feet in diameter. Chris A was helping out with the brush wad. There's a stump right there. We're gonna have to go high. Kind of out toward that big bushy one right there. So, if we take a look, we see that it's hanging over this way about 3-4 feet as well. I think it's going to give my hijacker a run for its money. And so I'm going to hope and pray by God's grace it's not a tussle and I have to get a backup with the featherweight. But honorable mention, we have a 661. This has a fully adjustable carburetor as well as an unlimited coil. So we're in the development stages. I'm giving this saw a run for its money. 3 foot, still lightweight bar with some full skip Oregon chain. The bark's still swelling. I don't know what the deal is. Fall, we're still dealing with bark swell. So that's been fun. But anyway, let us begin this session.
Thank you. Thank you.
pretty close. make it. That's the way it goes. There was a stump about 60 feet off to the right. It was hanging out quite a ways. This tree held on super awesome. A lot of them are drifting, so I had it gunned a little bit high to kind of compensate. Probably that spruce helped keep it in line a little bit, but I guess we'll go check it out now. So I think it's right there.
Yeah.
we had this towed down over the bank, and Chris A gave me a little bit of a hand piling a bunch of brush, but I noticed when the tree went down that the brush crushed a little bit too much. One of the things we were trying to miss is there's a stump right underneath there. You can see it's pretty high. And so I had that tree gunned pretty high. It was about 6 feet on the stump across the hinge. Second cut, we watched my saw flop down the hill because I was bucking right in a knot and that wood didn't release. So in lieu of holding on for dear life and going down over the bank with the saw, I let go of it, obviously. And then we sent this one in here across, which is a pretty nice tree. And you can see there's some fatties right there. So the second cut was about 50, 48 by about 51. I kind of tried to take a diagonal crisscross and check it out. 55 on the first cut, and then it was 48 and 48. So we ended up getting the meat out of it, essentially. Like I said, we're trying to miss that stump and that stump, and it didn't drift at all, and it had like about 5 feet of diagonal off to the left lean. If you look at the tree from the base, we kind of plumbed it, but I don't know how much of the end of the limbing and bucking we actually ended up with on video. And so kind of reviewing the volume, or check the description for that, I'll tally it up and put it in there. But anyway, thanks for watching this session, and have a blessed day wherever you might be on God's green earth. We're kind of in the land of the toads here. That one goes, that big one goes, big old Mondo one over there, another 6 footer in there, I think. So anyway, yeah, thanks for watching.